Hey, so welcome back to the channel. This is Rustin Lemon, the second road of the show series, episode 19. And today I found the coolest custom stadium ever. This will be we did have another custom stadium, that was for the minor leagues. And now we are not the home team, so I did have to change the Tigers and the Philly stadium, but this is what it's called. It's actually made by a different person. I just made my own to raise the altitude and whatnot. The original creator is Huggy Bear 0001 or 001. And this is what the stadium looks like. I changed it to have max elevation, the year it was opened, and the name of it. So this is where we're going to be playing today. Guardians 61-43, Philly 68-34.
One down, Big Daddy Ace, ready to hit. Homer last night added another hit as well.
It's a couple days since I played this. I played all the way to the 99 seriously, trying to get my team to fit any closer to Dino.
A sinker, a four seamer, a curve, a changeup, and occasionally uses a cutter. Bounce to the left side, and there's two away.
Should be pretty easy to hit home runs here.
One out, base is empty.
You know, with Merrifield up to the plate. And the wall may look a little bit higher than it is, so they're just red shipping.
Down the right field line and a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Brown is not hitting it. Two of the most potent offenses in the game.
Capacity is 6,000. Spear, sinker, cutter, forcing that 12-6 from Taiwan Walker.
Yeah, a foul ball.
I'm really early in on top of things right now. Number 7 on the prospect, second right field, and first Cleveland. Just completely mislocated the PC hand there. Like how it's like all the houses are on a hill.
The Guardians up big in this one here in game one of this 3-game set. Next pitch misses, and that's ball one. One ball,
two strikes.
And another ball.
Getting frustrating. It's the fifth pitch already.
Still 2-2 after the foul ball.
It's a little early on that. Squared it up for the ball.
Wait, huh? Wow, this guy's really battling up there. As if his run is
pitch
the
number 8
is
coming.
I love his tenacity. Outside of that is ball 4. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs?
Man at first, Big Daddy Ace digs in for the Guardians.
Should be easy at the stadium with high base hit.
Into the outfield base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out. Well, he waited until the seventh. Big Daddy Ace digs in for the Guardians. One for three. Swing and a miss. One on.
Going to a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Up and in. One ball, one strike. The Guardians up big in this one here at the top of the ninth. Swing and a ball lifted left field under it.
That's not my home run here.
One away.
That's max elevation. Square that one up just a little early on. That's what you want.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll, and that's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Players start hitting up and down the lineup. Never
technically,
going to come up with a big hit.
Also,
who's going to come out of the bullpen and get the big outs? But it's a good feeling that you are.
Big Daddy
digs
in for the Guardians.
Forcing cutters rotating in all six from Colby Allard.
Allard back to Allard. In for a strike.
Pitch.
It's 0-1.
No, he's really working that inside corner with
the Phillies first
and
down.
He needed that pitch.
That was
so tough to get the barrel to and to keep it fair.
I think the D-backs were one of the best record in the league.
Marsh moving back. And
gone.
He circles the bases. It's 3-0. That adds another
21st homer, 97.2 miles per hour from
bat,
378 feet.
Well at the plate and clearly driving the ball with some authority as part of that. He's really dangerous with the bat in his hands right now. That was one of those home runs.
The white dude. Good daddy. Here's a swing
like
and a
drop.
That one's back. Gone.
Gone. Three run bomb.
A gigantic blast. His second home run of the game.
His second home run of the season.
And
12.5 miles per hour for that 4-3.
They only need one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off. They thought he could blow a high fastball by him, but he was ready for it. Look at how quickly he jumped on that pitch.
Hitting those rocks is going to be
coming. The inning getting started. Stepping up for the Guardians, Big Daddy Ace. Risky, back to work.
Risky.
That takes low for ball one.
You know, these Guardians digging into their numbers have to be happy with the swings they're taking. They have five extra base hits on the stat sheet so far, and that tells me they're seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well.
I think the bat went flying or something.
This one drilled to left.
Now the ball's going flying.
Hit the house
with it.
Massive home run. That's his third home run of the game.
23rd home run of the year. He had 7.7 miles per hour for that.
4.8. Yeah, another big swing of the bat for him. Man, he is really seeing the ball well in this one. He's putting on quite the show with the dish here in this one, and he's just so locked in with the swing. And...
So digging in, Big Daddy Ace. And a chance to make some history here, Chris.
Yeah, he's had a great time so far, and now he gets another chance. At least we think
it's rarer than that.
Gives him anything to hit. It's so rare to see a three-homer performance, but even more special for that player to get another chance at the plate to do it again for four.
I'm pretty sure four home run games are rarer than perfect games for no hitters on the hit.
In the air, left
just
field.
A little under it.
Marsh moving under it. He's got it, and that is that. Here's Trey Turner. These two offenses can put up runs in a hurry.
All right, that speed in most of his garden, I'm not say at least 90.
Hard ground ball, base knock.
Maybe it's speed in. Road to the show.
Lead runner touches second, heading for third.
He's done it again, Boog. That's his 30th save of the year as he puts another game to bed. Sweet dreams, everyone.
If he case isn't better this time. Another interview. As long as your performance had the name player of the guy. Is this the same thing that I've seen a couple different times? The three dumb ones in this one I was gone, right? So it makes all the contact. What will you do to keep things rolling? Christopher Sanchez on the mound, sinker, circle change in the slider.
And a pitch.
Auburn, just for a starting pitcher.
Ball one.
Hold off the sinker.
And a pitch.
Stop donning the edges with sinkers. 2-3.
The pitch stays alive.
Still let come right there on me on him. Enter the zone.
His fourth home run of the series.
24th home run and 2.3 miles per hour to bat, 398. 24 home runs this season, too. That's a lot too Baker's dozen, so he's like 26.
And a foul ball. Hitter's got some good opposite field power.
Before home runs first on the Guardians, and we got him included. Then now you're 6 points for the rest of them. Get down. Nope. Perfect, perfect. Sink right by like a red bottom line. Yellow seats. 5-10 in the series with 4 home runs and 6 RBIs. Running 3-2.
Christian Pache.
We have more home runs than we do.
And that's a fair ball. Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much. One down, runner first.
Christian McKenzie seems to always be on the plate for some reason.
One down, Phillies down a run. Swings and lines one towards the gap. And that's a base hit.
E-A-A-D-X.
Here comes the throw, and he's safe.
Barely.
So it's first and third with one down. Well, just a nice job coming forward. And now the right fielder, Big Daddy Ace. He's already homered in this game. Walker, 31 years old, the former first round pick in 2010.
Force him in 26.
That puts the corner.
What?
Two down, nobody on. You're the third.
I don't think that's a strike, sir. That doesn't look like a strike to me.
Up the middle. And that chance handled. Now the throw to first on the run. And that'll do it. Whit Merrifield.
Still
in
the game 4-2. Try to sweep Philly here.
Hit in the air, right field.
3.
He won't get there. That should be extra bases. The throw to third.
Got him.
The tag. And he's out.
Out.
Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here.
Oh, God, don't hit a home run, Schwarber. That won't help him take the lead. Schwarber. Closer to our gold market. Two more assists. 10 more hits. More extra base hits. For the next series.
Detroit,
Jake Rogers. The only Rangers to the game are a team this far above 500 will be swept the team.
Line to the right. It gets down. Base hit. I wasn't that far under that. I hit home runs that look like that pretty much. Rogers brings it in, and there's two away. Bottom of the inning, and now Zach McKinstry. That one ripped. And that should be extra bases.
I'm sure if I could do this.
Disrupting the hitter's timing with the mix of pitches and changing speeds. You want to keep that front foot inconsistent with the batter. Their swings are hesitant, and that's exactly what you want on the mound. Brings it in with a nice running grab. And there's two away. And we're back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the left fielder.
And the 2-2. Mitt. I think he had his best season with the Cubs.
Swing and a foul back, that's out of play.
Or some splitter.
What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has it. Oh, and this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone.
Come back a little bit here.
A gigantic blast. Homer number 25 of the year.
111 miles per hour, 447 feet.
This dude is on fire, boom. These kinds of streaks just don't come around too often. Oh, that one got in the jet stream. Well, this team just hadn't been playing fundamentally sound baseball. But today they put it together. They should start them rolling now. You have to pay attention to the details. If you do that with good pitching, good defense.
Good chance to grab in 3 runs here. The homer. Get down.
Out towards right center field, Carpenter on the move, snags it on a run. Here comes the runner from third. He'll score on the sack fly on the board first. It's one zip. So many times that.
Driven another RBI, 51 men. 1-2. Forcing slider serpentine and a sinker for a little best.
Simply getting the bat on the ball in this game, and the numbers back that up. Only 2 strikeouts so far, and obviously they've been able to pick up plenty of hits, so it's been an impressive one. Green makes the grab, 1 away. And you know, that's right. Big Daddy Ace digs in for the Guardians. He's already homered here in this one.
Alex Lang, knuckle curve.
Just a little on top of it. It's on to Canna, and they're down to their last out. These 2-game series have a different feel. There's kind of an urgency, so to come in and take both games sweep the series feels really good. You kind of wish that it was a 3 or 4 game.
What are the standings now? We went. We won 3 of 5 games in this episode. Because of that, we're not down to second place again. But we're in the wild card here, so. Very close in the AL Central between the Twins and the Guardians. Not really able to swear, but. Alright, that's the end of this episode. See you guys next time. Bye bye.